Hi friends, thanks for joining. Today I am processing tomatoes and I apologize about the window behind me, but I'm able to get you a full view. It's the only place for my camera. So we're gonna go ahead and process tomatoes. Doing a tomato sauce, not a spaghetti sauce, a tomato sauce that can be used for a plethora of different recipes, and you can build upon that sauce according to what the recipe or dinner that dish that you're making needs. This is just going to have onion and garlic in it. I do have some can jars of Rotel tomatoes that I did, and a few of them when I canned them did not seal, so therefore they're in my refrigerator. I may be adding that to a couple different batches, but we'll wait and see how that goes. So I have some, we didn't have a good harvest of onions this year. So I have a few red onions from the garden. They weren't very big. This is actually the mesh bags that I got on Amazon that are wonderful. They have the drawstring on them, and I use these to dry my herbs also. And then we have some white onions. Look how tiny these are. These are the baby ones, tiny, tiny. So we're gonna go ahead and get the onions started. I'm cutting them up. I'm gonna put them in my food processor here. I also have a bag that I keep in my freezer for scraps. Including onions, carrots, any vegetable scraps that you would use in a broth, because I actually make my own homemade bone broth, chicken and beef, and we just recently, and we should be getting in about 3 weeks, half of a beef and a whole hog. So I'm gonna try my skills at some ham bone broth, so we'll see how that goes. But I save all my scraps and I put them in the freezer. And then just a little tip, if you want a nice colored broth, I mean a beautiful golden broth, definitely save your onion skins, the peels. The skins, peels, they give you a beautiful color in your bone broth. So we've got that going on. I'm also got my KitchenAid out over here, and there is an attachment on it. It is called the fruit and vegetable strainer. You do need two parts to that. So you need to actually have the meat grinder for the KitchenAid, and then the fruit and vegetable strainer attaches to that meat grinder. So here is an actual picture of the fruit and vegetable strainer, because I know you probably can't see it over there, but as the day progresses, I'll be taking you down from your perch right there, and we'll see if we can get you a view from over there. So when I start using that. Right now, my tomatoes are in the sink. I freeze my tomatoes because, of course, my harvest doesn't come in at the same time, and I'm not really wanting to do a bunch of small batches. I want to do a large batch. So therefore, I freeze my tomatoes. And honestly, it's a game changer if you freeze them, because when you start to unthaw them, let me find a tiny one here. Get this towel. So here's the tomato. That skin comes off so easy. So I would definitely suggest, unless you like the whole boiling them fresh and then straining them and having to touch those hot tomatoes and burn your fingertips, that's definitely, I mean, that was the way that my mom and my grandma did it. I just find freezing them is so much easier for me. I work a full-time job. I really don't have a lot of time to be doing that. And just like, you know, straining, there were times in the past where I was using my emulsifier and or a blender and blending the skins and the seeds. Nothing's 100% seed proof, but I really don't like my seeds. And with the Rotel tomatoes that I did. I did not deseed them using the strainer. I just went ahead and cooked them down, and there's a lot of seeds in there. But, you know, that's fine. I mean, you're getting Rotel tomatoes. All right, so I'm on the red onions right now and putting all the skins and everything in my bag for my broth and putting the onions into my food processor. These things are so tiny. You know, the problem was is that I planted them too close together. That really inhibited them. My carrots too. I had some alien looking carrots. But have you ever seen the size of a carrot seed? Those things are so tiny. Apparently this one didn't dry out on my onion. It started to grow. So we are not gonna put that in my beef broth scraps. All right. The red onions are done. I bought some from the store because of our sad little harvest with our onions. I think as the year progresses to next year, I'm actually going to start saving these mesh containers that they come in and save them for my harvest on onions next year. And hopefully we have a better produce selection from the garden. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and start on these and I'll bring you back in a little bit. So we're moving along. I have some onions in the food processor. I need to actually cut down. I still have a few of my onions that are not gonna be able to fit in there until I do. We have got our bone broth scrap bag ready. I've got my Dutch oven cast iron ready to go because we're gonna cook the onions and the garlic down in this. So let's go ahead and get these pulsed. I apologize if this gets too loud. And just enough FYI, my dog hates this sound of any type of electrical appliance. So I'm gonna go put him outside right now. Come on, Major. Go on outside. Go in. Yeah, he doesn't like those sounds. Should see it when they're actually, when they are. Okay, that's good for now. I just need to give myself some more space. So I am very excited, and why the reason I'm doing this now is I'm trying to clear up some space in our freezer. Because we just purchased from a local farmer 350-pound beef and a 200-pound hog. So I'm really excited for that. It's just, as far as full-time residents here in our home, it is just my fiance and I. But I have three children. I have grandchildren. And normally Sundays, are the day that, you know, we try to do something. Not all of them. My daughter lives in Columbia, Tennessee, which is on the outskirts of Nashville. My other son and his wife, their children, my grandchildren, are so active in sports, and they excel at those things too, and it's very exciting for them. And then my youngest son, he also lives locally, little one, so they have a little bit more time to come over. All right, I'm gonna get these pulsated. We'll get them in here and get them sweating, add some salt to them so we can get everything sweated. We'll get the garlic all diced up, minced up, and we should be good to go. And I'll bring you back here in a minute. Take a little break here with my coffee. What I've done is I went ahead, all those onions I really felt were gonna be more than I needed. Maybe more than I needed. So I went ahead and put 2 cups in freezer bags for future recipes. Now then, I'm not gonna put these in the freezer yet. In the event that this does not end up being enough. My plan is, this is my first year on using the KitchenAid. And what this does is it separates, if I didn't say this already, it separates the pulp and the skin from the juice. And it's a very, just tomato juice, very thin, not thick at all. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna like that. I know I could cook that down to make it thicker, but I'm also gonna pull out my roaster and put half of those in the roaster. And we're gonna have little seeds in there. So we'll see. It's kind of an experimentation day. Yeah, and I'd strongly suggest the bag for your bone broth if you do bone broth. Comes in handy, because I usually make enough bone broth that I'm doing multiple chicken carcasses, and I do it in my roaster. So I have a full roaster full of bone broth, and it's so wonderful when you need chicken broth, beef broth. You just have to go downstairs or go to wherever your pantry is and grab that out, and you flavor it to how you want it, and it's marvelous. All right, so let me get going on the garlic. We got peeled garlic. I just need to cut the ends off, and then we're gonna put it in the food processor. I didn't even bother cleaning out my food processor from using it for the onions, because it's all going to the same place. I'm hoping this will be able to chop it up like I want it to. If not, I may have to bring out my little speedy pulsator mincer. Really don't want to do that, because I really don't want a lot of dishes. So, let me get this done. Larger onion needed chopped up and added. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and pulsate these garlic, get them added to the onions, get that turned on, and can start on the tomatoes. In the meantime, I threw my garlic heads in there that I had just cut off. Get all the air out of there. Did you ever notice how if you use these things repeatedly, that zip kind of doesn't work as well? All right, in the freezer. food processor did a wonderful job. So we're gonna add those into our onions. Too much on my counter. Alexa, stop. All right, we have everything in here that needs to be in here. I'm gonna cook these down. Turn on the heat. On my oven, I have the little safety gadgets on my knobs. Reason being is that last knob over there is awfully close to where you do a lot of things. You may rub up against it, whatever. And I have a gas stove. And there have been times that I've walked in here or been somewhere else, what is that smell? It's gas. Come in and somebody's bumped it. So I've put these on here. All right, we're gonna let this cook down and get things straightened up, cleaned up a little bit, and move on to the tomatoes. We're gonna go ahead and add some salt to our onion and garlic. And there it goes. Woodrow, it's okay. And we got fresh peppercorn. Woodrow. It's okay. Stop. No. Go outside. He listens well, can't you tell? This mixture over here, the onions and the garlic, it's actually boiling. So I'm going to turn that down. I don't want anything to burn. It's on a very low flame right now because I have a gas stove. And I have to find the lid to that and we'll put the lid on there. I've got you at a different angle. We're actually going to be putting this unfrozen, the tomatoes that have unfrozen, into this KitchenAid attachment apparatus. The tomatoes go in here. They then go into this, which draws out the pulp and the skins. It goes into, the juice goes into this bowl, and all of the disregarded pulp seeds goes into that bowl. So let's try this. I'm not a fan of your view here. Not only that, you're right beside the sink, and I sure don't want my phone to fall in there. Alexa, stop. Because these tomatoes have been soaking, they're very drippy. Thank you. Hey friends, so we've got the garlic on and the onions. It's cooking down right now. We've got the KitchenAid working here. We've got a nice bunch of goodies. This is the pulp and the seed in there. We've got a nice canister of bowl of juice up to here. I've stopped that process because, as I mentioned, I want to actually do an experiment and seeing which path I like the best. So I'm going to only take the skin off of these tomatoes, put them in here, and then into the roaster so they can cook down. I don't know which one I like, but we're gonna try it. And I think I'm gonna use these. I'm just gonna leave the skins in here because when I drain this water, I'm going to save those skins. I'm going to dehydrate them. All right, folks, so this is the onion, the red onion with the garlic. If you ever have this happen, do not panic. This is just the oxidation of the, and the color. Mixing with the chemicals in the red onion to the garlic, so it'll turn another color. You'll find that in fire cider if you use red onion in your fire cider and garlic. So we've got the pot of the tomato juice from the KitchenAid, and we've got the tomatoes that are in the roaster. I'm just gonna let these cook down and get that mess cleaned up. Now then, KitchenAid definitely makes a mess because there's juice going everywhere. I'm gonna have to clean that up. But this is the pulp. I'm actually gonna run this through the KitchenAid one more time to get all that liquid out of there, and then we're gonna dehydrate. We've got the salsa verde going. It's a brown color because I've added some smoked paprika to that and my taco seasoning in there. Can also be used as a salsa with chips. Something I just threw together. I didn't want to waste my green tomatoes. We've got the KitchenAid strained tomatoes going with garlic and onion that we had processed today. And that is cooking down. I've added salt and pepper to that also. Then we've got the tomatoes that we had the skins removed. Of course, they were not deseeded, and those are in here. I did add my homemade Rotel tomatoes that did not seal during the canning process last week that have been in my refrigerator. I did add 3 quarts to this. So we've got everything cooking. Just needs to thicken up for us, and I will jar them. I will do a pH test on them to make sure that they've got the pH needed prior to going in the canning. And again, I'll be putting in salt and lemon juice into each one of the quart jars when we process to make sure we stay within safety FDA guidelines. All right, I'll be back. We also have this bowl of goodness. This is all the skins, pulp, seeds from the red tomatoes and the green tomatoes, and we're going to dehydrate these shortly. Our salsa verde, which really isn't a verde anymore. I added some of my tomatoes to that. Just needed a little something more. It has, you can clearly see, it's clearly cooked down. So we're going to let that cool down, and I'll be canning that. And tomatoes need to be water bathed. We've got the sauce, spaghetti sauce. I have since added dried parsley, dried basil, and dried oregano from the garden. And we put that in there. And these are the stewed tomatoes for a chili base. We've got cumin, chili powder, all the good stuff, with some homegrown jalapenos,
has onions in there. And those are seeds, not garlic. So I will be water bathing all of these. Quarts will be 40 minutes. Excuse me, quarts will be 45 minutes water bath. Pints are 40 minutes. And based upon your altitude, you would need to look at that for your PSI on your canner. If you're interested in seeing more of the tomato canning, we'll go ahead and record that in a separate video. So I wanted to say thank you, friends, for joining me today. It was a long day. I'm glad it's done, and we'll have that canning video up soon. You have a great day, and hit the follow button, hit like, so you can keep an eye on any other videos. All right, guys, have a good one.